Power BI Feature Overview. Learn about Power BI Premium Load Evaluation, Overload, and Autoscale. The metric-driven approach of the Premium Gen 2 platform offers additional benefits on top of existing Power BI Premium benefits. Using Premium Gen 2 provides peace of mind that your Power BI solutions will perform reliably, even when load on your capacity increases. If load crosses the capacity limits, the outcome is predictable and keeps all solutions functional. Using Autoscale provides an additional option to opt out of the predictable degradation of overload. Most importantly, the new Gen 2 platform lets any operation requested to first complete and afterwards evaluates the CPU power used with a simple metric. The utilization evaluations are performed every 30 seconds. Only once an operation completes, it is taken into account for the periodic evaluation. The evaluation sums up the CPU core time required to complete all operations that completed during the 30-second evaluation interval, and compares the sum against your capacity's CPU total power. Your capacity's CPU power is derived from how many back-end cores it has, with each back-end core adding 30 seconds of CPU processing power to your total power. Different operations on different types of Power BI artifacts may apply their contribution to the evaluation differently, but the principle of completing the operation, reporting CPU power used, summing it up, and comparing remains. For example, slow-running or background operations like dataset refreshes typically have very large CPU time values for the whole operation. To reduce the impact of these high CPU time values, the refresh's CPU cost is evenly spread over 24 hours from when they complete. Interactive or fast operations like report interactions are accounted for in the 30-second evaluation interval that takes place during their completion time. Similar to refreshes, heavier operations like complex measures may get spread over multiple half-minute slots to prevent frequent spiking of CPU on the capacity. No limitations are set on the amount of ongoing refreshes as long as the capacity is not overloaded. Instead, aggregating the 24-hour spread cost for all background operations in a day leaves a baseline utilization that is attributed as the load due to refreshes. Total load evaluation, interactive and background combined, should remain below 100% utilization, which is defined by how many back-end cores your capacity have. Total memory used to process an artifact, for example, a dataset, data flow, or paginated report, must not exceed the capacity memory limit. If the artifact exceeds the size limit, all currently running operations against it will fail. Consider this for import mode datasets refreshes, as they require more than twice the memory footprint to perform a refresh, since queries that may run against the original copy of the dataset still require memory while the copy of the dataset is being refreshed. Let's discuss overloading versus autoscaling. Premium Gen 2 evaluates your utilization up to 100%. Execution is still fastest, meaning no throttles on the actual processing of operations. However, if utilization exceeds 100% and autoscale is not set up or is maxed out, new interactive operations like on-screen report interactions will experience a temporary interactive request delay. This means the processing start time for the operations is intentionally delayed. The delay is proportional to the amount of overload and will persist until the load evaluation is back under 100%. You can opt in to autoscaling with a valid Azure subscription. If your autoscale is not maxed out and your utilization is evaluated over 100%, Your capacity will grow by 1 V-core for a 24-hour period to support the additional load. This single V-core is split 50-50 between front-end and back-end cores. Back-end core utilization evaluation will use an additional half V-core. Note that your artifact size limits in memory will not change. You can use the Gen 2 Metrics app to see how much request delay time was applied on your capacity and how many users experienced it. Using these two data points, you can make informed decisions whether you should turn on autoscale or not by determining your tolerance level to end-user performance degradation due to overload. Autoscale gives you the flexibility to use as much capacity as you need when you need it by adding a temporary V-core to your capacity for 24 hours at a time. To set up autoscale, use the Azure subscription of your choice. Select your resource group where V-cores will get spun up automatically when needed, and choose your autoscale maximum setting. Besides setting the maximum autoscale setting, you can control your spend on autoscale using existing Azure subscription budget management and cost spending features. Once autoscale is enabled, operations will always perform at top speed and will not slow down when the load on the capacity exceeds the capacity limits. With the new capacity management user experience, administrators can configure proactive and custom threshold email alerts using the Admin Gen 2 portal. Admins can adjust when capacity emails are triggered to send. For example, when a specified capacity utilization level has been crossed, when the capacity becomes overloaded, or when their Power BI capacity is autoscaling. Note that in order to set up email rules for incoming emails for ticketing systems, etc., emails will be received from no-reply-powerbi@microsoft.com. Visit powerbi.microsoft.com for more information about Power BI Premium Gen 2. Additional information about all Premium Gen 2 features is available at these links. Thank you for watching.